Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace be upon you and welcome to another episode of Ramadan Reflections brought to you by Reflection Path and the Zaytouna Primary School. It's come to an end and this beautiful month has so swiftly gone by. And it, as a beautiful guest that has come to us, it's now about to leave. But it doesn't leave without leaving gifts for us. And in this episode, we'll be talking about what gifts we have taken from Ramadan that we can carry forward after this blessed month. I'm sure you'll all agree with me that this has been an immensely blessed month. This month of Ramadan, in which it brings so many beautiful reminders. Reminders about the Quran, reminders about the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, reminders about the family of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who departed or who arrived in this blessed month. But now it's about to leave, and what is absolutely crucial is that we do not allow the gifts that we have gathered during this month to stay in this month only and not take them away with us. And so this month has taught us some great lessons, and it's really taught us how to discipline ourselves and remain grounded in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whilst also carrying on with our daily routine and the daily necessities that we have. And so one of the great habits and traditions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that we see is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam takes this gift and this routine of fasting in the month of Ramadan outside of Ramadan. We know that the first day of Shawwal is the day of Eid. It's the day of the reward for the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we can't fast on that day. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us in a hadith that man sama Ramadan wa atba'ahu bi sittin min ash-Shawwal kana ka siyam ad-dahr. That whoever fasts for the month of Ramadan and then follows it with six fasts of Shawwal, it's as though he has fasted for the entire year. And the scholars commentate on this and they say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards deeds tenfold. This is generosity. We give a little, He rewards it with much. And this is the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and His storehouses and His rewards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showers upon us. And so when we fast for the 30 days of Ramadan, or even 29 days, and we follow it with 6 days, then it's 36 days of fasting. Multiply that by 10, that's 360 days of fasting. That's the amount of reward that you get. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam firstly wants us to take away this gift of fasting from this month of Ramadan. Don't leave it just in the month of Ramadan. Carry it on with you. It's a beautiful act of worship and self-discipline. We're seeing a growing trend now of nutritionalists, of health advisors, you know, people, famous people on the internet now who are practicing intermittent fasting and participating in the 5-2 diet. This is a tradition that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us from the teachings of Islam. The other lesson that we take from this month is the Quran. The Quran. That we ensure that we do not leave the Quran in Ramadan. And we come out of Ramadan and now there's no connection with the Quran. The Quran isn't only for the month of Ramadan. The Quran is for life. The Quran gives us life. And it gives us the purpose of existence and life. And it gives us the routine and it gives us the guidance for life. Life isn't life without the Quran. And so we need to take the Quran away with us. Fasting, the Quran. The third thing is the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the middle of the night. Even if it's only 5 minutes, even if it's 10 minutes, just waking up, just being awake in the night and worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to stand at night till his feet were swollen in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when Sayyidatuna Aisha radiallahu anha asked him why, he said, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. That should I not be a grateful slave? This is gratitude. Doing what Allah has told us to do, the farad, the obligation, that is our obligation. We're just doing what we're meant to do. But going above and beyond, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us above and beyond what we deserve. And so we also worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala above and beyond what He has demanded from us. And that is a display of love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, worshipping Him when He asks you to is a display of obedience. Worshipping Him more than He has asked you to do is an act of love. And we want to develop this relationship of love with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the final thing that we take out of the month of Ramadan is routine and discipline. You can do it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has shown us people are able to wake up before Fajr for Suhoor. People are able to stay awake into the night for Salatul Taraweeh. They're able to fast during the day. Worshipping is not difficult. We may think that it's difficult. We may be out of routine. But the month of Ramadan has given us this routine now. We need to carry it out of the month of Ramadan. And joining ourselves and our communities and our families in the blessings of Ramadan, in these beautiful actions. And without a doubt that this month will, for those who truly attach to it, they will leave with the objective, which is the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah tells us that we have prescribed fasting upon you so that you may attain piety, taqwa. So when you exit this month, you should feel spiritually uplifted. You should feel a new connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a renewed connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that now we will hold on even tighter, and we will not let go of, and we will not destroy, and we will not diminish by committing sins or doing that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is displeased with. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of our worship during this blessed month, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala overlooks any deficiencies that we may have had due to our human nature. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on our behalf to reward the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, through whom he guided us to this blessed month of Ramadan and the actions to perform during this month. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Jazakumullah khair. Thank you for watching another episode of Ramadan Reflections. Please like, share and subscribe using the social media links below.